Hello everybody, I'm Balkan and in this video I'm going fishing for walleye at Emerald Lake. I'm gonna be using fishing gear that unlocks at level 7 or under, and this way if you're a lower level you know that you can actually go and fish successfully for walleye at Emerald Lake. Walleye is a very good option for leveling up and getting some money. It pretty much solves your money problem once you get the hang of it, and it's fun too. So let's go. Fishing for walleye in a rainy day you can do all day long. Doesn't have to be through any peak times or anything, just you can start at any point. Also, I'm gonna be using two setups. I have a spinning setup with a Walleye Spin 190 Callisto XSR 1400 mono 0.2 mm and narrow spoon 7 grams silver. For my other one I'm using a feeder rod with the same reel, same mono line sinker 15 grams, mono leader 0.12, number one hook, and I will be using small minnows for bait. So what's good for level 7 is that you unlock the small minnows, and on top of that at level 6 you unlock the little slingshot holder. This way I can go and fish with two rods at the same time, which increases my chances to catch a fish, and I know that I'll be catching at a faster rate than I would if it was just one rod at this level. I know this is not the best way to catch walleye, but for level 7 gear it works pretty well. So I'm gonna set up my slingshot first. And I want to cast towards this tree here, anywhere between 14-60 meters. I'll work my way and see which one works for the day. It could be different. I'll start with 60 meters and see if I get any hits on it. While I'm waiting, I'll cast my narrow spoon using speed 3 on it. I'll do a simple stop and go, reeling the lure upwards and then let it sink and so on until I see the lure stays somewhere, doesn't sink down, and I know that I have to set the hook. I think I've already gotten a hit on my feeder rod, so I'm gonna try to set the hook. And there is a fish there. I don't know what kind of fish there is, but it's possible you catch yellow perch or any of the pickerels. Also a crappie, but just because it's a bigger bait, the small minnows, even if you catch anything else, chances are it's gonna be a trophy one. So I got my first fish and I wonder what the fish is. Okay, my first walleye. That's a smaller guy. It's not as big, it's less than kilogram, but it's still good money. So I know that the 60 meter mark works for now. I'm gonna do the same. Until I hit a dry spell on it, I'm not gonna change my distance. If I do, I'll reduce it with 5 meters. And I'll do increments like that until I get a fish again. Oh, okay, here it is. I had a nice hit and I set the hook. This already feels good, like I'm getting enough fish. And here is another walleye. At level 9 you can unlock the purple narrow spoon, which I think is better than the silver one, but as you can see, the silver one also works. Now I have a bite on my feeder rod. I'm gonna wait a little bit. This looks serious now. I'm gonna try to set the hook. Alright. And another fish. Just to run some math here. So the spinning setup will cost you about 2700. And the feeder one will cost you about 3400. That's without the rod stand. So we're talking both setups to purchase is about 6500 with some bait too. But you can get your money back very fast. This fish is really nice to catch for money. It's just, it doesn't get any better that early in the game. It's a nice good fish and gives also very good solid experience. It's another walleye. This one is a little bigger now. You can also catch some sauger or whatever. I don't know how you actually pronounce that. Is it sauger? Is it sauger? I'm not sure. It looks very similar to the walleye. It's just brownish. And alright, keep doing my thing. And if you're a higher level, you don't have to fish with two only. You can have a rod stand that can hold more than one. You can come here with more rods, and you can even fish off the little dock there if you have a rod stand that actually can be set up like a tripod style. If you can't, this place here also works just fine. Alright. That's another fish. Good stuff, guys. And it's very easy. There is no specific way of doing it. It's not tricky or anything like that, especially on a rainy day. I mean, you have pretty much the same chance of catching the fish all day long. I think the problem you'll run onto is that your fish keeper is not big enough. So and see how much fish I'll catch in 1 hour. Oh, that was another one. And about using narrow spoons and setting the hook, it really comes with more practice. I was really, I mean really bad using any type of lure, but the more you do it, the more comfortable you get, the more you start to recognize when to set the hook. You just have to keep an eye on that lure on the top right corner and see when it freezes instead of free falling in the water. It stays somewhere and you have to set the hook. Require some reaction, but it doesn't always work even if you react to it. Another walleye, that's a good one. I do want to catch a trophy. At this point I'm not getting anything on my feeder rod. I'm gonna most probably recast it after this one. and I'll try a different distance. I'll try maybe, I don't know, anything between 40 and 60 really. I may go for 45 and see what 45 does for me. Alright, narrow spoon silver does the job. I don't think I'll catch any trophies with this, but or if I do, it's gonna be a rare occasion. However, even common ones are pretty good. Oh, oops. Alright, I thought I had it. A smaller guy. And let's see. 3500, 20 kilograms, and 19 fish in 3 hours. That's about what I'm gonna catch with this setup. Maybe a little bit better, 2.5 hours instead of 3, but it's not a bad fishing day at all. And I got 1, 2, 3, 4 trophy yellow perch and 1 trophy walleye. So I'm gonna go and forward time first. Let me see. Okay, this is my second day of fishing for walleye. This time I'm thinking to forward the clock to night fishing at 9 p.m. It's not a rainy day, so I want to go to the night fishing. I did try fishing in the morning in a day like that in a different occasion, and it's pretty much half the fish. I'll catch half the amount for the same time than I would in the night like that or in the rain. It's the same idea. I'll throw the same places, same technique, same everything. It's just in the night, nothing complicated. And really, this is a very good way to catch walleye early on. You can start doing this at level 7 and your bottleneck will actually be the keep net, the fish keep. So if you're level 8, your total will be 12 kilograms. If you're level 10, your total will be 15. If you're level 13, total will be 20. So in 2.5 hours, 3 hours, I was able to catch about 20 kilograms, which pretty much is, if you're level 13 and you have a fish keeper that unlocks at level 13. If you're level 7, like with all the gear here, your total limit will be 10 kilograms, but it's still a very good option to go. And here is a fish I caught from my second cast. Very easy, guys. Level 7 equipment. But I do use 2 rods simultaneously. 1 feeder rod and 1 with a spinning rod and spinning reel. If you wanna gain experience and money, I think at level 7 and up, this is the place to be. Just go for walleye, you won't be sorry. It's one of those cornerstones in the game. You just have to take advantage of it. my first day I caught about 20 kilograms of fish in 3 hours, and this is my second day. After 2.5 hours I caught again 20 kilograms with 17 fish. I even got a trophy walleye, and to reward of over 3700. So with one fishing day, if you have your fish keeper big enough, you can totally stay here for a bit and get your money back and actually farm some walleye for money. So if you're level 13 and in your total max is 20 kilograms every day, 20 kilograms is about 3800 every day. Consider all the expenses you have, including bait and all that, it's still very good money that early on. This is all from me. I'm Balkan. Cheers and take care. This was a guide on how to fish for walleye early on.